Arbor Farm Initiative is like a think tank based theoretically in Arab world, but practically we are in Paris. It's also a way to understand why we are in Paris, because we cannot, could not be based in Arab world under dictatorship everywhere from the east to the east. The West. I will show you some. We have 20 members, Arab Center, Research Center, University, and also think tank in Arab world. We have also, we decide to have also individual membership, especially from country who people cannot organize themselves in think tank or on research center, as Saudi Arabia or somewhere else. We have eminent intellectual who represent the intellectual body in their country. They are member also in Arab Reform Initiative. Here you have global names of the members. You can see from Egypt, because it's a very important country, unfortunately now in very bad situation, but we have 5 partners in Egypt, and even we have the Bibliotheca Alexandrina, who is member, because they have a section called Arab Reform Forum in the Bibliotheca. Of course, here you have the list of names, but you have more or less 4 to 5 very efficient centers who work hardly with us. Others, they have their own problems, they have their own restrictions. For example, Egypt now, before the Arab Spring, we used to work closely with all those centers. Now, some of them, they cannot go and talk with foreigners. Foreigners, even if we are Arab, we're still foreigners for some observer in their security apparatchik. I still with Egyptian case, because when you see here Al Ahram Center for Political and Strategic Studies, it's the famous Ahram newspaper. They have a think tank close to them, but they used to be more independent before the revolution. Paradoxically, they used to be more independent before the revolution. Now they have a new direction, and they are very aware of their movement, of their activity. They are less involved with us, but they still very interested, and they participate to all our conference, but they don't produce any more studies or paper for us. Arab Forum for Alternative, it's NGO, very active, who produce many paper, but now with the new laws in Egypt, they cannot anymore receive any fund from outside. It's considered like a crime from the new authority, and they have a huge problem, but we continue to help them, to support them. Partners in Development, it's a think tank working on the development issues and economic issues. Mustafa, Professor Mustafa Kamel Said, very known economist in Arab world, he's on head of this association, and they do a very good work. Bibliotheca Alexandrina, they are less involved, depend to their link, very close link to the new military regime, but they still good group of Egyptian intellectuals involved in the question of reform, but theoretically only. When we can, in Arab world, talk about reform theoretically every day, but when we try to translate this reform on the practice, it's become more difficult and dangerous for the leaders. And as you see, we have Lebanese Center for Policy Studies. It's very known think tank based in Beirut. And they do a very good job in economic issue and political issue. We have Moroccan, very active center in Morocco. The Palestinian center also, even if the situation in Palestine is very difficult, but they do a very good job, especially they have a small team they make survey, not only in Palestine, but in all the Arab world. They help us to produce our Arab Barometer for Democracy with 44 indicators. King Faisal Center, it's from Saudi Arabia. The president is the Prince Turkey. It's the prince we considered the most reformator prince in the royal family, but they don't exist. They exist only theoretically with us, but they are very inactive generally, not only with us, because they don't Turkey have many problems with the family. He don't want to be more active inside Saudi Arabia. And we have Sudanese Study Center based, unfortunately, in Cairo, because it's forbidden to work inside Sudan. We have Sana Center also based in Amman, in Jordan, because we cannot anymore stay in Syria. The Syrian League for Citizenship based in Lebanon also. All the Arab centers are in exile, more than less. Very objective issue, it's a positive issue, it's the Tunisian issue. Now Tunisia, it's the only success in the Arab Spring for the moment. We hope it can continue. And the Tunisian are new members with us, and they do very good job for us, for themselves and for us, because we are like a consortium of think tank. We provide them with many help. We try to organize, to coordinate project with them, and to make transversal work between from Morocco to Saudi Arabia to Yemen to other countries. We have also the Gulf Research Center. He is no more in Dubai. He is in Geneva, because even in Dubai it's become very difficult for independent researcher to work without control of the state. They are based in Geneva. Yemeni Observatory for Human Rights, unfortunately also, because the war now in Yemen, they are based in Cairo. The American and European partners, they are Casa Arabe, Madrid. It's one of the first partner in Europe. Center for European Reform, London, UK. Eliamep in Greece. They used to be very active, but now with the Greek crisis, they don't have any more fund, and but they are very involved in our activity, because they are interested about the Mediterranean space. European Institute for Security Studies, the former director, he is now one of our senior researcher, Alvaro de Vasconcelos. He's based now in Sao Paulo, but he worked with us closely. He used to fund this European Institute for Security Studies. It's the think tank of European Union. It's depend to the official to European Union, and we have, as I announced in the beginning, the University of 3 February, and U.S. Middle East project in New York. Our main issue is to produce knowledge. We published many papers, many studies, not only small studies, but also what we call e-book, because we believe that it's very difficult for a think tank to print books and to distribute books. We can print, but the distribution is very complicated, especially in the Arab world. We decide to make what we call e-book, and we have all our production in our website. We have also, we decide to re-grant young researcher in Arab world, not especially Arab researcher, but scholars who work on the Arab issues. Can be French, can be Argentinian, can be American, but they are involved or interested by Arab issues. And this support for Arab youth researcher was a very successful project. We have also some survey. We organize some survey. Now we are interested by Syria, also Egypt. We work with some group of survey to focus on the main issue in those countries. Before the Arab Spring, we use, because we are funded in 2005, in 2006 we start with what we call critical dialogue between the opposition forces in Arab world. We put together the Islamists and the leftists and the liberals since 2006, before the Arab Spring. And we are very happy now to see many of them involved in the political process, even in Tunisia, in Morocco. Our chair is Professor Abdullah Saaf. He used to be the Minister of Education in Morocco with the government of reform of Youssefi, famous government of reform, who started the reform in Morocco in 19s. They are very involved also. In Egypt we have many of our scholars who become MP, member of parliament after the revolution, but now we don't have any more parliament in Egypt, it's another issue. In Yemen, many of our scholars was involved in the process of transition after the revolution in Yemen. And we are very happy to see that our dialogue between leftists and Islamists and liberal produce some effect. It's depend somewhere, it's not in all the situation the same, but in Tunisia, because, for example, we are very happy to see our friends who talk together till now, to work together, to organize together some event. And it's one of our very positive results. We have now many research projects, but the main or the most important is security in time of transition, living constitutions, social mobilization and the challenge of representation of social demands, and governance of diversity. It's very important to talk about those projects here in Argentina, because for the first one, security in time of transition, we used to work with many researchers from Latin America and Central America, especially from Chile and from Peru and from Colombia, about the security in time of transition, how to reform security sector, how to reform the military body after transition to a democracy. And we published many papers comparatively between Chile and Arab country. And we are, if our title is Arab Reform Initiative, but we are very open to other experience, and especially Latin America, Spain, Portugal. We used to work with the first civilian minister of defense in Spain, Narcís García. His expertise on the transition from state security to republican security, it's very important for us. Also for the constitutions, we used to work with Brazilian, mainly Sao Paulo Center of Brazilian Studies, and we published a book talking about the Brazilian experience, Turkish experience, and Portuguese experience, and how the Arab world can benefit from those experiences. For the social mobilization, it's a very new program, and we have mainly Egyptian scholars, young scholars, who try to produce not only case study, but also theoretic framework for this issue. Governance of diversity, as you know, in Arab world we have this big and difficult and complicated problem of diversity, who used to be managed by the dictatorship to divide more and more the society to better control them. And we try to think about how to develop, to increase a good governance of diversity. We have now the Moroccan experience. The Moroccan government recognized now two official language for the country. It's very new in Arab world, and we try to see closely how this experience can continue and can be success for other country. And of course, I can answer in the question answer about the each detail of each program. And of course, we try. It's not to be nice and to be in positive position concerning the Western country, but we try to respect the equality between women and men in our activity. We have all the time half and half of men and women as scholars. We push them to be more involved in the work, not in our mind, it's not an Orientalist way to see things, but because we believe on the role of women. Our executive director is a woman, Professor Khuzami, know her very well, Madame Basma Kodmani. She is very involved since 20 years on the issue of reform, political reform especially. And here we have our young scholars, some picture just to see how those new scholars, because in Arab world, as you know, the dictatorship don't encourage research, don't support any young researcher, and for that we have a less researcher in relatively than other area, because people, even if they do a good PhD, they prefer to teach, because make research don't bring any salary, any help, financial or more recognized. Here you have individual supported, and we support also some organized some new initiative. Madame Musk, it's a very new website, for example, where you can read things on the Egyptian case. It's not under censorship of the state. It's not under the control of the Muslim Brother. It's a very liberal website, and you can find in many all the opinion with the respect of each other, of course. Here, Ittijahat, it's a group of intellectual and artists in Arab world who decide to develop a new political culture policy. We support them. Al Jumhuriya, the Republic, is a new website also talking about this Syrian situation. We support them. And Ila Suriya, also Syrian website. We try to support them all. Here you have the activity, how we organize this support of young researcher. We organize for them a meeting. We ask them to write a paper. We revise the paper, and as also usual in the Arab world, people even they write article of opinion or article, a very long article. We try to learn, to teach them how to make what we call in the Western language policy paper with recommendation, with a very clear idea, without rhetoric, to go straight to the target. The Arab Barometer, we have now many barometer in the world: African Barometer, Asian Barometer, Arab Barometer, and we are a member of this network of Barometer, International Barometer. We try to cover 12 countries. It's not easy at all, because to make the Arab Barometer, we need to contact people, to talk to people, to ask for law, to read the law, and to ask about the situation, political situation, and the state of democracy, and it's not easy at all. Some country we cannot do that, this activity, because the regime still very closed. Now we focus on two countries, because we found those countries very problematic, and for the future of the Arab Spring can be the impact can be or very negative or very positive. Egypt, we talk about management of security challenges, return to old practices, and now if we observe the situation in Egypt, it's a real return to old practice, and sometimes worse. People regret Mubarak time, because the torture now, the situation of censorship, it's worse than under Mubarak. We talk about failure reform attempts, public policy, especially access to information in Egypt, and social mobilization. For Syria, it's very difficult now, because we publish many papers. Every month we have two papers at least on Syrian issue, on the security, civil military relations, and it's very important to us to have the experience of Latin America and Central America, because on the security, civil military relations, not security sector reform, security, civil military relation, it's very important for us. We discuss with Paulo Coelho in, our friend from Brazil, he helped us to have a good idea on this issue. Transition justice for Syria, also Latin America experience, very important for us. Not Spanish experience, because in Spain it was, we turn the page, we forget everything. We don't want to forget everything, but in the same time we don't want to punish all the people who are involved, because now after 5 years of killing in Syria, we have more than at least 100,000 people who can be considered as criminal of war. And it's not possible in any transitional justice to do it. But we try to have a level of this. And also in the public policy, we try to organize for future Syria a system of local governance and decentralization and recognizing of diversity in Syria, because we have more than two ethnicity, we have 5 to 6 ethnicity. Of course, the majority is Arab, but we have also the minority, not only Christian and other religious minority, but also ethnic minority. Our publication, it's 5-4 category. Jadal, it's called what it means debate. It's small article. Policy alternative, it's what we call policy paper, research papers, and report. Now we have many we send all our publication to a mailing list of over than 11,000 addresses, but in the same time we know that our readers are more and more day after day, because we open our pages for a serious publication for serious scholars, and especially young scholars and local scholars who cannot find opportunity to publish their paper because they don't have the name, they don't have the international recognition. And we are covered by, we are solicited by all those media in the world to comment on all the event in the Arab world, but also in Arab relation with other countries. It's our new logo. we try to mix the Arabic language with Latin letters. And thank you for listening, and I am open for all your questions to develop about this issue, and if you want, about the political issue and this issue.